Hey guys, today we're going to be installing a CPU air cooler into an LGA 1700 motherboard socket. During the video, I'll give some universal tips that will help you with more than this exact same cooler here. For demonstration purposes, we will be using a Cooler Master Hyper 212, and this motherboard is a B660M. When it comes to CPU air coolers, you can install them while the motherboard is outside or inside the case, but I do recommend fully prepping your motherboard first, as some larger coolers can affect the installation of the RAM or even access to the top M.2 slot. Everything you see here will be included with your cooler, and it's the parts we need for the installation. This is the LGA 1700 parts, and we do receive some parts for other sockets as well, but we're not going to be using these ones today. The first step of the installation is prepping our backplate. Super easy today with this LGA 1700, there's actually nothing for us to do, but some other sockets might require a screw that goes through the backplate, then you clip it into place. All we have to do is lift the motherboard up and line it up with those four holes in the back. And once it's in, just carefully place the motherboard on top, making sure it doesn't move. Up next will be our mounting brackets. These will differ between sockets and coolers. Sometimes they actually screw into the backplate on top of the motherboard. For us today, they're going straight to the sides of the cooler. We do have to prep this one first and remove this fan. Quite an easy design. Just simply pull and unclip both sides, and the fan comes straight off. Place the mounting bracket on top of the base plate here. And then with the provided screws, we just want to place them and secure it from the bottom. Just repeat this process for the opposite side. All coolers will come with thermal paste. You'll either get a little tiny tube like this, or you'll have some pre-applied at the bottom of the base plate already. Either way, make sure there's some on the CPU before installing and making contact for the first time. Remember to peel that warning label off the bottom of the base plate. And then as for the orientation, just find the top of the logo and line up with the top of the motherboard, and then carefully line it up with the screw holes on the base plate. Once contact is made, just apply pressure to the cooler just to evenly spread that thermal paste. Before reattaching our fan, just check the orientation so the air flows through the heatsink, cooling things down, and the placement of the cable just to keep things tidy later on. Place the fan clips back into the holes in the fans, and then place the fan back onto the side of the cooler, and then they just clip into the side fins on the heatsink, like so. The final step for us to do is to connect our fan to the appropriate header on the motherboard, and we do want to make sure we're using that CPU fan header. It is normally around the top section, however, it is best to just check your motherboard manual. Do keep in mind that some air coolers do have support for multiple fans, including this one. If that is the case, make sure you're using an appropriate fan splitter to connect all your fans to that CPU header on the motherboard. And that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions about anything we've gone over today, or if you have a different cooler and you're having a bit of a problem, let me know in the comments below and I'll try and help you out as best I can. As always, thanks for watching.